On top of being a teacher, now I'm Dr. Iglesias, unlicensed ghetto therapist.
You need to focus less on your kids and more on what matters.
Don't say.
All the single ladies in Long Beach.
A, B, N.
It's headphones nailed!
What's up, guys? Headphones Neil here, back with another Netflix review, and in this case, it's going to be the three seasons worth of episodes for Mr. Iglesias. This is a TV show starring, of course, Gabriel Iglesias, Fluffy the comedian, in the role of a teacher in a high school, and basically the ups and downs of being a teacher. So he's specifically a history teacher, and he kind of brings his flavor of comedy into this TV show. So rather than being situations to fit around the various stories that he tells in his stand-up, he translates the lessons that are learned and the voices that he's done and his abilities to do voices into teaching his students and the life lessons he uses with other teachers and faculty and dealing with the president and vice president and all of that. So for me, overall, watching the show, I enjoyed it more than I was expecting because of all those things. So from my memory of it, and it's something that I might want to go back and do, is rewatch other similar shows like the John Mulaney show, which I don't remember what it was called, but just to see how that stands up, because that felt a lot more of the flip side, where he would introduce situations to bring his stand-up into the TV show, and then it felt too much like a modern day Seinfeld or an updated version of Seinfeld, so it kind of didn't hit home as well as I was hoping, especially since I find John Mulaney to be a funny comedian or a funny stand-up comedian. So if you're a fan of Gabriel Iglesias, then you'll definitely enjoy Mr. Iglesias as a teacher. He does his voices, he has the life lessons, he is basically himself as a down-to-earth person and teaching the students, and how he gets himself inadvertently into various situations and then working himself out of it via feedback from the other teachers and faculty, the principal, the students, the parents, and things like that, and then dealing with going to Alcoholics Anonymous and not having any, not being able to drink, and making sure he sticks to the plan as far as not drinking anymore. So, all in all, the three seasons were a good watch, and I definitely enjoyed all three seasons, and I actually want more. So doing a quick bit of research online, I saw that it's kind of up in the air because of COVID, so we don't know if they're going to come back, if they're going to have another season with the same students, or how they're going to progress the show, or if there's going to be if there's even going to be more episodes of the show. But overall, if you're a fan of him, I definitely recommend watching the three seasons. They're all like 10 episodes or less at about 25 to 30 minutes each, so it's a relatively quick watch, and it's lighthearted, funny. You get to like each of the characters. They don't really spend too much time as far as backstories on the character, so when you learn their personalities, it's easy to like all of them, and overall the characters just generally mesh well together. So if I was to grade it, I give it a solid A, just because it was funny, it was lighthearted, you relate to all the characters, whether it's students, teachers, parents, or anything like that, and all the various situations and scenarios. So that's really all there is for this particular review. It's pretty quick, it's overall a good show, and there's not really too much to say without spoiling it, so I'm going to leave it there. So if you have not watched it, I definitely recommend watching it. If you have seen it, let me know what your thoughts are. Do you think the show nails a comedy? Do you think it doesn't work or anything like that? But like I said, for me, I liked it, so I definitely recommend giving it a watch. And it left me wanting more and to have more situations with fluffy with the students, with the teachers, whether it's the same teachers or if they bring in a few different cast members with students, if they keep the same students for their senior year or bring in a new class, and if they make it a rotating class or something like that. But overall, well done. And if anything, I would want maybe one more season where the kids are in their senior year, having to deal with COVID, and then also having to deal with college applications and round out that particular storyline, or story arc. So that's all there is for this particular review. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, or anything like that, you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. The website is headphonesneil.reviews for past episodes, subscription links, supporting the show. And if you want to check out the gallery of pictures to see what you can do with mobile photography, that's also on the website. And of course, you can support the show on Patreon at patreon.com/PatelN01 for supporting the show, bonus content, and early access to upcoming content and things like that. But that's all there is for this particular episode. Thanks for tuning in, and until next time.